We've had one hell of a time putting together this sumptuous beach house for Kun Kuei, or more formally, Disappoint Chancery, and everybody is charmed with the results. Kun Kuei approached us in 2011 with a recent acquisition of perhaps one of the most unique beach houses in Phuket. This property on Kamala Bay was built in the 1970s by a rather flamboyant Frenchman and his Thai partner, long before there are anything like setback laws. The result is a home that one can never build today under the current regulations, as it is built right on top of the high tide line. The song of the waves is an intrinsic part of the estate. The land size is a bit peculiar in that it is some 100 meters of shoreline, but only 25 meters deep. The flamboyant Frenchie had just the right idea, and that was to build five small but comfortable bedrooms and to connect them with only the lushest of gardens. Architecture he built was one of a kind in that the pitch of the roof was too shallow. The tiered roofs were over the top and the overhang of the roofs were far too little. But we took all of that in stride and adopted the fault as being part of a distinct character. Our mission was to make a fully functioning beach house with all of the strange, quirky ideas that made the home so appealing to Kuei in the first place. We drew every section, every plan, 10 times and studied every angle for months. We decided to let an aqua turquoise and a cool gray palette percolate through every corner of every small but gorgeous room. We were resolute in the idea that the furniture was to be very comfortable and simple and accentuated by eclectic antiques. The finest ivory linens from Jim Thompson were selected for the window coverings. Auden Chirichai searched Bangkok's bevy of boutiques with a fine-tooth comb to bring home a marvelous range of pickings. Chirichai and I, for 2 years, would pick up unusual finds from the many places that we visited abroad. Wonderful prints from Amsterdam, columns from Delhi, silver cornucopia from London, and intricate needlecraft from Peru. We selected intricately hand-embroidered bedspreads from the stacks and stacks in the dusty workshops of Jaipur. Shortly after we were engaged with this dream project, we accompanied Kuei on a shopping trip to my favorite antique stores in Sri Lanka. We bought a number of beautiful ebony chairs and a magnificent Dutch cabinet, which is now in Kuei's bedroom. Kuei also bought a lovely painting by a Swiss lady that's been living and painting in Colombo for a number of years, which also adorns his bedroom. We designed and ordered all the casually shaped turquoise and vermilion tableware from Chiang Mai. The 30-plus oil paintings in the estate were all done in-house at Bensley Studios. Thousands of details were consciously thought about with one goal in mind, and that was to simply update this lovely, quirky home with as much thought and care as its original creators, as flamboyant as they were.